Good morning, students. Today we are going to know and understand the famous Canadian fantasy adventure novel Life of Pi, written by N. Martell, and it was published in 2001. N. Martell, who became internationally famous for his publication of Life of Pi in 2001. He was awarded the Man Booker Prize in 2002. The narrator of this story, Pi Patel, an Indian boy from Pondicherry, was named by his parents Pisain Molitor Patel. When he was in secondary school, he changed his name Pi. His parents owned a local zoo and Pi took interest on the animals, especially a Bengal tiger named Richard Parker. Pi's father, Santosh Patel, always forced him to witness the tiger killing a goat, so that he wanted to prove that tiger was a carnivore and always to prove that it was a dangerous animal. Pi was raised a Hindu and vegetarian, and when he was 12 years old, he was introduced to Christianity and then Islam and started to follow all three religions as he just wanted to love God. When Pi was 16 years old, his father decided to close the zoo and move his family to Canada. He wanted to ensure a good future for his children by selling the zoo. So they booked for a trip to North America on a Japanese freighter named the Simsom. What is freighter? Large ship designed to carry goods in bulk. The freighter, that is Japanese freighter named Simsom. The journey continued. After a few days out of port, their ship encountered a severe storm and began to sink. Pi managed to escape in a small lifeboat that also he was thrown by one of his crew members, only to realize that the boat also holded a spotted hyena, a royal Bengal tiger, an injured zebra, and an orangutan named Orange Juice. Much to the boy's distress, the hyena killed the zebra and then orangutan. The presence of the hyena posed a threat to Pi, and later it was killed by the tiger. Pi's mind was preoccupied only with thirst and nothing else. He was searching for food and water on the boat. Finally, he saw many tins of water just below the tarpaulin. Tarpaulin means is a waterproof cloth. Usually they keep it in the boat or ship somewhere. He slowly moved towards the tins, took three of them and quenched his thirst. He was delighted and it brought him hope, surprise, disbelief, thrill and gratitude. Pi came to life after drinking the elixir of life. Here elixir of life is the water. The elixir means the purpose of living. That is, here water is the main source of prolong his life. So he mentioned as elixir of life. Pi managed to quench his thirst in this way for the remaining 124 days. The tiger, which scared Pi in the beginning, became ironically the source of peace to him. The tiger and the Pi had to live together. They were literally and figuratively sailing in the same boat. In the present situation, the animal toughness of Richard Parker may outlast Pi's human frailty. Frailty means weakness. The only possible means of outliving Richard Parker was to tame him. But Pi wanted the tiger not to die, because if he died, he would be left alone with despair. That is, living alone is considered to be the great dangerous than the tiger. Pi realized that it was because of Richard Parker that he had the will to live, that is determination to live. The tiger helped him stop thinking more about his family and his tragic situations. Pi openly stated that without Richard Parker, he would not be alive today to tell us his story. Pi left Richard Parker in a forest and waited for a ship. The tiger went into the forest without having a look at Pi. This pained Pi very much. Finally, a ship found Pi and he was reunited with his family. Though he reunited with his family, still he weeps that the tiger had walked away without him. This is the story of life of Pi, what we have. Actually, Pi now married, living in Canada. And also, we know very well, Life of Pi is a well-known, famous film. Hope many students have seen this film. If you have an opportunity, have a glance. Thank you, students. Bye.